YouTube, what's the word, man? Glad to bring y'all a crazy gameplay right here. It's not necessarily the most wildest game. This is just real high-level Madden. I got a chance to sit down. I was playing Drag for some money. Drag is a longtime member of EMB. Been in the Madden community for as long as I can remember. I don't even think anybody remembers when he came into the community because it just seems like he's always been here. Definitely played a lot of big stakes money games. He was the Packers Club Series champion last year. Made a long run. Actually, didn't think he was going to compete last year, but wound up making a long run in the Packers Club. And that was good for him to go ahead and he started competing. This year, obviously, he's back. EMB member, so you know what he knows what he's doing, playing with Joke and Ghost and those guys that are really competitive. So it's nice to go ahead and play somebody that knows what they're doing. He's running a little 3-3-5 normal, which I haven't seen too much. I play well against this. It's not odd. There's no loop. I feel like I'm very comfortable blocking this pressure. But he's mixing up his coverages very well here. Here we get a second. He's able to hit the comeback there to Dorsett. Nice job. I feel like when somebody mixes up their coverages, I kind of got to run a couple different plays. But majority of my plays, it's probably two plays mixed up with a bunch of hot routes. If you want to check out my ebook, the link is below. I'm going to play a lot more of these salary cap games coming down here, getting close to everybody else's Club Series tournaments. And you see I fumble right there with Tyreek Hill, I believe. I had taken a lot of hits, and the next play we go ahead and come back and get a pick with Apke. My first drive, I did take a lot of hits with Vic, so that fumble wasn't huge, wasn't a big deal. Here you go, Apke, little bait to the right, come back to the left. When I see they run the play with the running back going to the flat, normally I hard flat, and I know the next read is the tight end there, so I baited a little bit to the right, made the tight end look open, and went ahead and got that pick with Apke. Right here, I tried a high ball, accidentally low ball. He should have got a pick, but Amos swatted it out of his hands. Next play, we're actually kind of boxy, man. Everybody would step back with Vic, move up, whoop, right by him. And this is why Michael Vick has to be your quarterback. This is the pocket presence to go ahead and see that I have an extra guard not blocking anybody. I'm waiting for him to send a spy. Please send a spy. I have nobody step back, so my guard picks him up. Get up out of there with the right trigger, sidestep him a little bit. It really wasn't that crazy of a move. It's just hard to tackle the quarterback in that situation. And there's nobody left in the open field. Michael Vick is just a difference maker at the quarterback position. So I'm going to go up 7-0. He's playing good defense, mixing up his coverage. Nothing's going to be easy against a high-level Madden player. I'm running a little 3-3-5 odd. Drag actually has one of the better trips in the country. I mean, he started really early in the Mudhead League playing with these trips, and it looked really good in Mudhead League. So I know he's got a lot of reps with it. There we go. We see Amos actually not make a play, but actually knock Will Tye back. He gets him to a 4th and 5. Here was a nice setup with the running back Will. I jump over there to running back Streak, and he has the corner route open. That was a nice little play setup. Got to remember that for down the line here. Once again, my hook curl and my 3-rack Dawkins not really covering anything. Bam, we see the screen right there underneath. He makes a tackle there with Jalen Ramsey. Throws to Steve Smith. There we finally get the 3-3-5. Glitchy A-gap. I know you guys are tired of playing against it, but we get it with Khalil Mack there. Nice play by him, 2nd and 20, taking the Will route. Overhead gets him, I think, 12 yards or 11 yards. Nice job on 2nd down, not forcing anything. He threads the needle here, but I got more in the L zone to knock it out. Get him to a 4th and 9. He can bank this field goal in from pretty deep, 37, 47, 55-yarder. Nice kick right there. Big play. I do play outdoors in Philadelphia, so the wind is always a factor in all the games I play. I mean, some people like it, some people don't, but I think it just adds an extra thing you got to think about in the game. I got boxed this play. I really just lost track of my reads. Really, it was a play I don't run that much. Next play, I step up a little bit. This is why we put Todd Gurley at tight end, because he can make plays after he catches the ball. Huge juke there. Get me an extra 10 yards, it looks like. Bang, he got a little shed there. That time I max protect. I'm telling you, max protect is not always the best thing to do, man. The tight end really does not pass off the blocks well. Here we go. This is why we put Moss on the slot, and we put him on a fade. Bomb that up over top of cover 3 there. He manned up Moss, and when you manned up Moss, you're going to lose. He's just too good. Needs to be on the field at all times. So we're up 14-3. We're up by 11 points. The all-coveted two-possession lead in Madden. So here we go. We get a nice little screamer by my guy, Phillips. I don't know who he is, but I think he has 76 speed. We get the loop right there with Moore. That's why you run this defense. You just hope they get the loop or the glitchy A-gap or something crazy every once in a while. And that drive alone, this defense got the stop for me. I mean, he didn't do anything different. I didn't do anything different, but we decided to just scream at him that drive. So now I had a ball. This is just a killer spot right now. I got to go ahead and get the points here. before the half. We're going to run this to the two-minute warning. Next play, run the ball. Ideally, honestly, between me and you guys, we're playing a player this caliber. The score 14-3 is good at halftime as we want to hit this curl to Tyreek Hill right here. 14-3 is good, but I'd obviously love to go ahead and put some more points on the board. I'm really using clock. I don't want to give him the ball back at all. That's pretty much the main goal. That's why I'm sneaking in a couple runs just to keep the clock going. And as you see here, instead of rushing, I let the clock run all the way down because it's a third down, and Linval Joseph gets free. He gave up the post there, but Linval Joseph saved it. Instead of going for this, I'm going to go ahead and punt. I wasn't creating field goal range. It's a bad job by me not getting back in the field goal range. But I'm just going to punt, knock him back in you know, the area here, because I feel if I went for that and didn't get it, he's pretty much already in field goal range. So I'm going to make him work. He has three timeouts. Nice job checking the ball down right there. Has a timeout, so he's able to use him. Right there, he goes two fade. Try to hit me with a cover three beater. I was in deep halves. Cover three beater did not work. Make a tackle. That's what you got to do. And here we go with Apke. Just a super bait on that play. I mean, be able to run with Will Ty and come all the way back to get Randy Moss. Apke's just a cheat code. He's got to be your user. Even in regular, he could be the user. Able to get a field goal here. And here, I got three timeouts. I don't know if I can make this. I don't know the wind. But I come out and field goal on first down. If I don't see it, I can call a timeout, run the ball, and call another timeout and get back on the field. But because I was able to make it right away, just take my field goal right away and give me 17 seconds. Squib kick, he can't get nothing. This is the start of the second half. I feel great. I'm up 14 points. I remember telling myself and the stream this at the time. 14 points feels great. Brian Dawkins in a hard flat almost ended the game for me there. Get him to a second down here. I covered the drag. Nice job fitting the post in here. That play is going to be so lethal if he can consistently throw the post there. We finally get a little pressure there. Jabal Sheard, I have it end this game. He went ahead and block shedded a little bit right there. Throw underneath Apke, make the tackle. It's feeling good right now. Just want to make him use some time here. Here he goes again with that post. Jeez, that's going to start killing me. It's going to make me switch up my defense a lot if he's hitting that post and throw underneath. Prepare for the truck. It's kind of like last year. You got to get ready for your first guy to get trucked and make a tackle. Although Moore pushes back Leonard Fournette here. Ramsey trying to get the ball out to end the game. A turnover would end the game at this situation. He goes for a running back wheel route. I'm on top of it. Send the spy, throw the ball away. Get him to a 3rd and 12. I mean, this is what it's about, making a stop here. He's actually chucks it underneath, chucks it down to Fournette. Able to pick up a big chunk of yardage. Get him a 4th and 2. When I played two man under, I put my safety in the yellow zone, and he just like ran to the A gap. Pretty wild there that happened, but you know, I gave up a touchdown there. Made it a little easy. I kind of got too cute playing the man coverage there down there in the goal line, but you know, he found a little dot. Like I said, I put my safety in the yellow zone. So now I'm up 7. We got to go ahead and make a play here. Though, as you see, I throw the ball to Gurley. We're going to spin with Gurley. That's why we have him there. Next play brings a crib. I go ahead and throw this post over to Tyreek Hill. See the guy coming from the left. Juke back. Boom, he bumps into another guy and then get out of there with Tyreek Hill. You run to the left a little bit, anticipating the dive. Don't run straight up the field. You got to use your angles to get away from defenders. And with that 94 speed, Tyreek Hill is pretty much a must-have on everybody's team. So, bang, right back up 14 points. So, like I said, we look at the time here on the clock. There's 1:30 left. I feel like, you know, let's just make him use this third quarter. I mean, if we let him check it down, we can get to the fourth quarter up 14. I feel great about this game. I don't want to give up the big play. Throw underneath, and he starts juking my user all over the field. That looked a little wild. But like I said, just want to make him use some time. And he actually hits me with a cover three beater. But Amos, I tried to swat, and they made me dive. I don't know. Maybe I should have went for a pick there and hoped to get a breakup. But he gets a big play there, running the ball. Like I said, I just want to get to the fourth quarter. We can take our time here, and he actually gets this high ball here to Tyreek Hill. Gets the perfect animation. Feet in bounds. Boom. So, damn, we're right back to 7 points. I mean, I can't sneak away. I can't make him. I didn't even get what I wanted there to make him use the whole third quarter. But I feel a couple good dots get me in field goal range, take some time, this game will be over. 7-point lead in the fourth quarter, that's what you're thinking about. But he screams at me right there with Shaquem Griffin with the nub making a sack. This time he rushes 4 people, hit him with a little hitch playmaker over here to Randy Moss. Get me all them yards back. Get me to a 3rd and short. I'm able to hold my water, but this contain finally got me. Wasn't blocked, but then stepped up and tackled my quarterback. 4th and 4, I'm able to hit this little zig the girly, spin to stay in bounds. Truck to fall forward just a little bit more. I'm at the 50-yard line. Let's use some of this clock. Are you up snapping it too? Try for the touchdown play, but Dorsett doesn't want to put his hands up. A little short maybe on that play. finally pop a draw for some decent yards. As you see me run the ball, it really doesn't work that well, but that draw went and popped for a couple yards. Snuck in a little man coverage. I'm going to hit this post lob over the top to Randy Moss. That's got me in field goal range. So now I'm just, okay, I'm up 7. I put it on conservative. I'm just going to run the ball. Run the ball. Take it there. Take it under the 2. Take it to the 2-minute warning here. He has 3 timeouts. I'm going to run again on 3rd and 7. I'm just going to make him use his timeout. He uses his timeout. I feel great right now. Kick my 3. Go up 10 points. It's not 14, but 10 points is all you really need. Now he's going to really try to force the ball. Throws underneath. That's clock ticking, clock ticking, clock ticking. Next play, he tries Myrick. 20 cap goon. Tries to throw over his head. Throws a pick. That'll end the game. So that was, I mean, high-level man at his best. Like I said, Drag is one of the better players in the country right now. I know his trips is one of the best, but I slowed it down, made him use some time. He did pick some plays. I caught a couple picks with Apke and played some good offense that game. That's what it's about. So check these games out live on my YouTube.